Hello, basketball fans. Great matchup for you tonight between the Oregon Ducks and the Washington Huskies. And here's a look at our Star Watch comparison. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
You need your starting five to be the unit who will be intense and also understand what the coach wants early in the game.
Teams are ready to go, and we're ready for the tip. And the first half has officially begun. The Huskies are currently ranked number 23 in the nation, Dick.
One thing I've realized over the years about rankings is that really you can't get too excited and too enthused being on top. You got to have your players understand it's about the postseason.
In the lane, off the mark. Gave it up.
Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Working it around the perimeter. Launches away. Perfectly executed. When you can pass and score like he does, it makes a coach's job a little bit easier, wouldn't you say, Dick?
He's the type of player who thrives in almost any offensive system. Very versatile and puts pressure on the defense.
Fires away. They got it. The center receives the ball. He shoots the jumper. Nails the jumper. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
The wing. They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Got it.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. He shoots the runner. He can't get the hoop to fall. Now they work it around the perimeter. Change of possession. Got him right where they want him, Dick. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. Green handles the pass. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Spacing.
Looks at a three. Number 12 is feeling great out there right now.
Hey, can you blame him, Red? He's getting it done.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Launches the three. Off the mark. Walker receives the ball. He goes for three, scorches the net with a J. Now looking to create with a ball screen.
Had a pick and roll is one play that so many teams use these days. A great one.
Swatted away. Moving it around the perimeter. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. There's a double team waiting there. Goes up. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up. From the corner, nails the J. They'll work it around the arc. He shoots from the corner. They get it to go. The Ducks got some good ball reversal there.
Hey, when each player on offense touches the ball on the perimeter, it forces the defense to move. Eventually, the defense will break down.
He buries the shot. Way out on the right wing. From right in the circle. And score it. The Ducks are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
You know, whether you're attacking the zone or man-to-man, getting the ball into the high post puts pressure on the defense.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Both teams looking to get things going here. On the outside. Bad decision there by the freshman. Here they go in transition. Goes up for two. He gets it to go. Inside. He makes a nice shot fake. He goes up with it.
Excellent jump shot right there.
On the outside.
Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
Looking for a good shot. Charging.
Kids, you got to see the whole floor, not just the hole.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Traps in place, Dick. Number 10 takes the pass. They look to get it to the ends. They get that rejected. On the right side. For the bucket. Makes the shot. Takes it strong to the hoop.
That comes when you're committed to being the strongest guy on the court. Every time you step on the floor, it takes an army to slow him down.
Had his shot blocked. Gave it up. For two. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Unusual mistake there by the senior.
On the left side.
Up and inside.
From the corner. Missed it. Takes his jumper. Goes up with it. The missed shot. He looks for three. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
But they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. He nails the bucket. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Momentary look from three-point land. The Huskies in transition.
Look at this going coast to coast. Nobody stops the ball. I mean, he just has an open lane, man. You can put a Mack truck through there.
He takes a three. Off the mark. Carter handles the feed. He tries the jumper. Knocks it down.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Well, they come with a double team to stop it. Green receives the ball. He attempts the jump shot. Scores it. That's a good-looking drive with a kick out there, Dick.
That's good offense for them. Attack the paint, suck the defense in, and then kick it out to the shooter.
Battle picks up the foul. Second and a chance to make it a three-point play.
Yeah, good second effort to stay with the right there. Did a great job attacking the defense. You know, Brown, as a coach, your seniors are a very important part of their operation. The underclassmen look up to them, really lean on them for guidance and direction. When a senior accepts this role and leads by example, it helps the coaching staff and the team immensely.
He may be in some trouble here. For the bucket, he gets that one to fall. On the right side, he draws a foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
He may be young, but if he's on the floor for this team, you know he's willing and able to contribute any way he can.
Steps to the line for an easy one. Misses the free one. Second one is no good. Walker receives the pass.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
Take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Nick.
He's a PTP, Brad, a five-time performer, a really talented kid. He knows the game and is showing everyone how much he loves playing.
Zone motion now. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Working around the perimeter. Outside jumper. Nope. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Two teams are picking it. No, you got to score that. You got to count it. You got to count it. He says no, but you count that.
And here's a snapshot of how they fare in their conference.
I don't know a coach who doesn't want to be at the top of this list. Conference play is really important, especially towards the end of the season.
They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
He's trapped, Brad.
And now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Looking for a good shot. Now with about 10 seconds to shoot. He pulls up with a jumper. Jumper won't go. on the left side. From the corner, can't get the shot to drop. Turnover committed by the freshman. The point guard receives the ball. Around 8 minutes remaining. For two. Great shot. They work the perimeter. From the top of the circle. Comes up empty. Gave it up. There may be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Step to the line for the free throw. He buries it.
Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
He may be in some trouble here. And the strip. Quick hand. Transition opportunity coming up. He gets the rejection. Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. Number one looks to record his first minutes.
He provides nice push offensively and defensively for this buck.
About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. Working it around the perimeter. The chanting continues.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Nice look on that backdoor pass, Dick.
They got caught sleeping. Great execution, great timing, a beautiful backdoor pass. Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from the top of the circle and come up short. They work it around the perimeter. He tries the three. Off the mark. Gave it up. We're at the 6 minute mark. Now they work it around the perimeter. Takes the jumper. Missed the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. Oh, nice rejection. Loose ball and batted in. And it's heading out of bounds. No, great save. Puts up the jumper. Gets the J to fall. Tries for two. Busts the J. Entry pass in the paint. He gets the tough layup and a foul to go with it, Dick.
Hey, that was awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Chance to get an easy one here. Routine. Number 33 makes his debut into the game.
I tell you, this kid comes in with fire, Brad. He really knows how to bring it.
He may be in some trouble here. We're at the 5 minute mark. Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. He puts up the J. Missed it. On the left side.
Look at that spacing.
And the ball is dribbled out of play. Number 12 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
That trap could spell some trouble. He rejects it. On the left side. Loose ball. Great play. Turnover by the freshman. On the left side. We're at the 4-minute mark. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Dick, was he there in time or not?
Oh, you betcha.
Number 4 comes back in.
You know, let's hope he didn't get too ice cold out there sitting on that pine. Sometimes you get to be a little frigid.
They've got him trapped, and it's knocked loose. On the wing for the bucket. You betcha. From the corner, he clangs the three-point attempt. On the right side. For two, it sticks. The shooting guard handles the feed. Number 12 is charged with the foul. Gave it up. Goes up. And score it. Top of the key. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Moving it around the perimeter. There's a slam. Throws it up. And we've got a change in possession here. Number 12, quickly checking back in.
They need him out there, Brad, just like I need you, man. This guy is the glue.
They've got him trapped. And the strip, quick hand. Pushing in transition.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high-riser.
They'll work it around the arc. Goes up for two. Buried it. On the dribble, gives it up. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Can't connect. Cleans the glass.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Here's a double team. Jumper. Nope. Hardy handles the pass. From the corner, off the glass and no good. Pritchard receives the pass. On the outside. One minute left to go. Pritchard receives the ball. Off the mark. On the left side. on the outside. Tries for two. Knocks it down. Fed the low block. He shoots the jumper. Jumper won't go. They got the offensive rebound and the stick back. Shot clock is dead. Number 10 is called for the foul. First personal foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Opportunity now for an easy one. First one is good.
Converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
They've got him right where they want him, Richard. Puts up the J. Off the mark. He goes up with it. Time, the Huskies trail by one. Washington has turned the ball over a lot more than normal in that first half.
They're very sloppy in moving the ball tonight, and as a result, turnovers are piling up like dirty laundry.
Well, let's take a look at our game summary to this point so far, Dick.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Number 12 comes back into the game.
I tell you, they need their leadership out there. This kid's got leadership skills just like you, Mr. Nestler.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the deep corner.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Gave it up. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. And you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability. He's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
Trying to feed the low block.
Got to take some pride on the defensive end.
How do you keep the man sealed on that double team, Dick?
Not like that, Brad. They really got to be active. Active hands, active feet.
Number 10 is whistled for the foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Well, he's just a freshman, but hey, we all got to start somewhere.
Well, Brad, it's a lot different from his high school days. This is a big business now. It's about maturing and ensuring that he gets better every day and develops into a great all-around student athlete.
Got him trapped.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Missed the jumper. And the jam. Dumps it in. He lets it go. Perfectly executed.
It inside.
He shoots from the top of the key. Can't get the shot to go. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. The missed shot. He shoots from the corner. Can't connect. And a momentary look from three-point land. Nope.
Check that basketball with that good defensive rebound. Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. With the J. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
This is a one-man show right now, Brad. This is supposed to be a team game.
They go into the low block. He makes the block. Green looks to be down emotionally.
Someone may have to talk to him. He needs to get back on track.
For the bucket. It's good. He tries the jumper. Missed it. The shooting guard gets the ball. On the dribble, gives it up.
Double team now, Matt Angle.
They work it around the perimeter from the corner and come up short. Buries it. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the coaching staff knew this would be a key heading into tonight's matchup. This is something they stressed during pregame, and it's something they're talking about on the benches right now. The message, get the ball inside. Guys, they're doing that.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, if you have a great post play, you got a chance really to win.
Gave it up. There's a defender flop, and he's going to pick up the foul.
Well, he's not trying to take the charge, but he's really acting. Good call by the official.
Looking for a good shot. The jumper off the mark on the right side. The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
Jumper won't go on the left side. Puts up the runner, and we're going the other way. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Three ball. Nails a sweet jumper. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
He takes the shot. Perfectly executed. They'll bring it back out on top and reset it.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box. I hate it when guys can't make that entry.
They work the perimeter. Jumper scorches the net with a J. Walker receives the pass. Working it around the perimeter. He shoots.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
For two, he gets the shot to fall. Perimeter. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Just their excitement with that jam. Turnover by the freshman.
Pushes it up. Lobs it.
They call for the lob and threw it down, baby.
Looking for the pick now.
Hey, a two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribbler and a skilled big man.
Not there. What kind of player do you need in order to play up-tempo, Dick?
You need to have players who have the aggressive mindset at the offensive end and can really impose their will at the defensive end. It's not easy to find those type of players, Brad.
Goes to the line, makes his first. Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Left him a nylon, NBN.
Attempts the trifecta. Off the mark. Hardy receives the ball. Goes up for two. The missed shot. Pushes it up. From the corner. The Ducks have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brady's on fire.
Well, we'll see if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
The Huskies go into their zone motion now. The Ducks now looking for a basket in transition. Tries for two. He shows the sweet touch. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on a perimeter. Get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
Now they work it around the perimeter. A little two-man action.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
From downtown. Can't connect. Pushes it up. He blocks the shot. Out on the wing. on the dribble, gives it up.
Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
The Huskies are beginning to get that additional exposure, especially with all the recent success in the postseason.
Hey, being successful isn't easy, Brad. Your program must be solid from top to bottom in order to be successful.
He attempts a jump shot, nails the jumper. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. There's a double team waiting there. For two, can't get it to go. Hardy handles the pass.
Look at that spacing.
From the corner, missed it. Pritchard receives the ball. That's an ill-advised shot.
Hey, Brown, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Down inside. Goes up for two. He drains the shot. Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner. Off the mark. Here they come with a double team to stop it. They'll work it around the arc from three-point territory. Missed the jumper. Oh, yes. The Huskies might be in some trouble here, Dick. They're going to have to put the pedal to the metal and really look to attack offensively to get some baskets.
Brad, it's basically do or die. They play up tempo so they could get back into this game. They need stops and quick scoring stuff. I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Traps in place, Dick. Around 8 minutes remaining. Walker comes up with it. And off the mark. And once again, our two featured players here in tonight's Star Watch. The Ducks are going to move away from their preferred style of play and look at playing a bit more in the half court here, Dick. They've got a lead to protect.
It'll be interesting to see if they make this change, Brad. At this point, I think it'll be most beneficial for them to concentrate on playing offense in the half court and, most importantly, keep the clock running.
For two, off the glass and no good. Feed the low post. He pulls up with a jumper. Nope. Pritchard on the right side. 7 minutes left on the game clock. There's the rejection. The freshman commits a turnover. The Ducks are on the run.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
Hard foul. A Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
He has a chance to cash him in. Hits that one. Sinks it. That trap could spell some trouble. The shooting guard takes the feed. Traps and play stick. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
The shooting guard with the ball. And the block. We approach 10 seconds now on the shot clock. For two, about 6 minutes remaining. Rims out. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
He misses the jumper. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Rims out. For the deuce. Lays it up. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
The shooting guard gets the ball. He shoots. Makes it. They've got to figure out a way to slow him down.
I'd start to get physical with him and I'd see what happens.
Goes up for two. And he misses the shot. The point guard takes the pass. On the outside. He tries the fadeaway. Busts the fadeaway, Jay. The shooting guard with the ball. Nails the sweet jumper. About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. Is the J. The layup is good. On the outside. He shoots from the corner. He misses from the outside. He misses the jumper. Nails the jumper. The students are all fired up and ready to do whatever's necessary to help their team win.
Oh, yes, the student body, always full of comedy and excitement.
3 minutes left on the game clock. Takes the jumper. Nails the J. Trying to feed inside. The senior commits a turnover. On the left side. Goes up for two. Off the backboard. Pritchard receives the ball. Looking for a good shot.
Bad decision there by the freshman.
Carter handles the feed. Cross court. He's all alone.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
2 minutes left on the game clock. Inside. He shoots from the deep corner. Perfectly executed.
It's a two-point game. The fans are going to make it even tougher, Brad.
You didn't expect him to quiet down, did you, Dick?
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He goes up with a jumper. He makes the jumper. It's a one-point game.
1 point usually means free throws, Brad. Inside.
Count that as a personal foul. Let's take another look at this deep three. Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
Second shot is good. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
The point guard handles the feed. About a minute remaining. And he just can't afford to get in foul trouble.
No, Brad. Coach doesn't want to have to limit his minutes.
He goes to the line for the first time. He hits the first shot. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
He sinks them both. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vital.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He shoots the jumper. He misses the J. Green handles the pass. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Ball's coming from the sideline. Shot clock is dead. Foul, and that stops the clock again. He finally fouls out.
He's a tough, tough player, though, Brad.
The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. And the clock stopped with a foul. He steps up to the line. Just like in practice. Second one is good.
They need a basket here to turn this into a one possession game.
And a timeout's called. We got a break in the action. Stay tuned for more NCAA basketball coverage. Timeout. They want to talk it over right here. And with that timeout, we go to the third member of our broadcast team. Aaron?
As you guys know, free throw shooting becomes very important down the stretch. The coaching staff is aware of this, and we'll be talking about this in the timeout. It'll be up to the players to knock them down.
You've got to be able to execute, and coming out of a timeout, I think it's really important, don't you, Dick?
You know, it's mandatory, Brad. I think it's crucial to have all five players on the same page and ready to execute. Your goal coming out of a timeout should be to get a stop or a score, depending on whether you're on offense or defense.
And we're back. Dick Vitale and Brad Nessler with you here, ready for the inbound after that timeout. That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
Cross court. He fires away. The missed shot.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
They cut the lead to two.
Hold on to your seat, Mr. Nessler. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Makes the second. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Get back to the action. On the right side, from way outside, and come up short. Washington finally pulls this close one out.
They expected to beat a victor. They just didn't expect it to be this close.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.